As a result of the slump in the animal nutrition business, slightly adverse currency exchange conditions, and the lack of performance from Amoy Food, where assets were lightened last year, our sales decreased in the first half of the year. In an unfortunate development which could not have been predicted at the beginning of the term, our joint venture in Africa, Promasidor, recorded impairment loss for the second consecutive term. In addition, although the African swine fever epidemic was expected to affect our animal nutrition business to a certain extent, it spread more widely than anticipated, exceeding the initial predictions. As for the full-year performance forecast, to put it simply, our animal nutrition business slump is not leveling off, but rather showing signs of further depreciation. Accordingly, declining sales trends will continue, and major risks remain related to the extent of declining profit. Our expectations are based on these factors. Regarding the items below business profit, within the section marked Other, which is 22.6 billion yen total, around 15 billion yen in structural reform costs has been included. These expenses reduce profit before income taxes as shown, and our initial forecast of 28.7% has been revised to 35.7%. This increase in income tax rate is due to the fact that a portion of Promasidor and animal nutrition business impairment loss will not be treated as deductible expenses. This concerns our approach to shareholder returns. Although our financial statements are unfortunate due to the aforementioned factors, our profitable businesses are earning favorable operating cash flow. For shareholder returns, we have determined to keep the initial prediction unchanged and pay out dividends of 16 yen per half year, 32 yen for the full year. With the exception of impairment loss, the total shareholder return for the past 3 years is 50.9%, just barely maintaining the levels promised.